Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all of you. Hope you are safe and sound at your home. Dear cadets of 43rd intake, that is class 7 of Bhushal Cadet College. At the very outset of my lecture, I would like to welcome you all in my online class of Bhushal Cadet College. You know, COVID-19 has made our daily life standstill. For this reason, your joining of Bhushal Cadet College is being delayed. But we cannot stop our regular activities, and our college authority has to bring you under online class. Considering this, now I, Satyajit Datta, Associate Professor of Economics and Housemaster of Soyed Sarov the House, have decided to take online class and expected that I will be with you for the next 80 minutes. Today's lesson and topic. Let's have a look into our today's lesson and topic. First of all, I would like to thank you for the participation of my previous class and exam. Boys, you do well. Today, my topic is Introduction to Population of Bangladesh. Lesson 4. 5 and 6, and the chapter 8. I hope you will enjoy the class, and let's start the class with the cadets of class 7. Learning outcomes: after the end of this lesson, cadets will be able to explain pressure of population against the natural resource of Bangladesh, discuss reasons and effects of population increase, and lastly explain steps necessary to mitigate population problem of Bangladesh. Now, keywords. First, child mortality. Death after this 1 month up to the completion of first birth anniversary falls into the category of child mortality. Second, neonatal mortality. If a baby dies within the first month of its birth, it is called neonatal mortality. Third, mortality of mothers. If mothers meet death before they give birth to their children, or for reasons after the birth of their children, it is called mortality of mothers. Lastly, poverty. Most people of Bangladesh are still living below the poverty line. Cadet, now I am discussing about the mother and child mortality in Bangladesh. At first, mortality of mother. Generally speaking, if mothers meet death before they give birth to their children, or for reasons after the birth of their children, it is called mortality of mothers. This kind of death is estimated per lakh. Secondly, child mortality. On the other hand, a newborn up to its 1 year of age is known as baby. If a baby meets its death during in this 1 year, it is called child mortality. Child mortality is estimated by the number of babies dead against a 1,000 newborn. If a baby dies within the first month of its birth, it is called neonatal mortality. Death after this 1 month up to the completion of first birth anniversary falls into the category of child mortality. Now, I am discussing about the maternal mortality situation in Bangladesh. In Bangladesh, in the year 1980, a total of 6,050 mothers died when giving birth to their children. In 1990, the number came down to 574, in 2001, 322, and in 2010, it decreased to 194. Now, I am discussing about the causes of maternal mortality. In our country, many girls conceive at an early age due to child marriage. These girls do not get proper nutrition due to, number one, ignorance. Number two, indifference. Third, religious superstition, etc. As a result, they suffer from various complications during their pregnancy and die. Besides, there are other reasons like one, low standard of life, two, lack of pure water and weak sanitation, number three, lack of female education, number four, lack of medical treatment, number five, risky abortion and high blood pressure during childbirth and eclampsia, etc. Now I am discussing about the effects of maternal mortality. Number one, in Bangladesh, the neonatal suffer from lack of nutrition due to maternal mortality. Consequently, the child loses its resistance to diseases and falls victim to diseases. Number two, in many cases, they die. Motherless children suffer from poor socialization. Number three, alternative milk is required for a newborn due to death of its mother. In poor families, they are usually given cow's milk or goat's milk. In these cases, the baby suffers from stomach disorder and some other complications. They need doctors. It is an extra burden over the poor family. Number four, apart from this, the remarriage of father also needs extra expenditure. Sometimes death of mother causes the family discipline to break down. Child mortality situation in Bangladesh. Bangladesh has achieved great success in controlling child mortality. A report published by UNICEF in 2008 shows the child mortality in 1990 in this country was 149 per 1,000. It came down to 69 in 2006. It was further decreased in 2008 with 52 deaths. It was further decreased in 2014 with 30 deaths. That proves child mortality is decreasing fast in this country. However, the rate of still much higher than that of the developed countries. Now, I am discussing about the causes behind child mortality. First, poverty. Most people of Bangladesh are still living below the poverty line. As a result, mother and child do not get proper health care and nutritious food. Most children die because of poverty. Number two, child marriage. Child marriage is still rampant in the country, which is most available in poor families. In the rural poor families, girls are married up at the age of 18 to 23. Their children take birth with weakness and malnutrition. In many cases, these children die due to physical complications. Number three, the rural midwives. The rural midwives who are not properly trained also causes the child mortality rate to go high. Number four, malnutrition and sickness of the mother. Malnutrition and sickness of the mother also affect the newborn to suffer from malnutrition. Malnutrition gives scope to many diseases. As a consequence, many infants die. Number five, some diseases. Though infant mortality due to measles, polio, tuberculosis, tetanus, diphtheria, whooping cough, etc. diseases have gone down all over our country. Still, they cause some death in some parts. They add to death of infants. Number six, difference between medical facilities. Difference between medical facilities available in rural and urban areas also play a role in higher mortality of infants in villages. Number seven, frequent natural disasters. Another reason is frequent natural disasters in the country. The cyclone of 29th April 1991, caused death to the total of about 1,38,000 lives in Bangladesh, of which 50% are children. Number eight, others. One, lack of education. Two, ignorance. Third, superstition and negligence are also responsible. Correct. Now I am discussing about the effects of child mortality. Number one, some of us are familiar with infant mortality in our families. A death of a child creates some sort of disorder in a family. It is hard to accept. Number two, many a times it becomes a cause of disturbance in the relationship between husband and wife as they accuse one another. This was in a host of problems, including divorce. Number three, high rate of child mortality is the reason parents prefer to have more children. It is also an impediment to socioeconomic development of the country. Number four, a child beginning from its pre-birth stage to its time of survival costs a lot of money on a family. Its death is naturally a financial loss for that family. The death of a child is a mental breakdown earning members of the family, to which creates disturbance in their regular life. Number five, in poor families, they take frequent babies due to child mortality. As a result, these children come with lesser weight, lesser intelligence, etc. Now, population and natural resources of Bangladesh. Natural resources are precious for a country. These resources are the base of its social, political, and even economic strength. The stronger a country is in natural resources, the stronger it is financially. There are some big countries like Canada, Russia, Saudi Arabia, and United States of America have huge stock of natural resources. Their stocks exceed their national demand. On the other hand, Bangladesh has forests, mineral, coal and gas, population, hard rocks, stones, etc. Natural resources. The population of Bangladesh is a pressure on these resources. Population of Bangladesh is increasing fast. Our country faces troubles to meet the demand of this huge population. Therefore, the country resorts to the resources to fill the need, which is creating a huge pressure on them. Number one, pressure on forest resources. Habitation problem for the huge population is taking a huge proportion to accommodate them. We need to build houses. Use of wood and materials of wood in constructing house is increasing pressure on our forest resources. As a result, forests are destroyed. This causes harm to natural balance. Presently, construction of infrastructures like houses, roads, highways, etc. is going on all over the country, including towns and villages. Number two, pressure on cultivated land. Increased population is a huge pressure on our cultivated land. Newer house to meet demand of houses or increased population mean use of cultivated land. Besides expansion of trade and commerce, industrialization and urbanization also use of cultivated land. Number three, pressure on gas and oil. To meet up daily necessities of huge population, Bangladesh needs to produce huge quantity of commodities. Wood, natural gas, and oil are used in the process as raw materials and fuel. As a consequence, natural resources are being depleted. production of electricity requires natural gas and coal, which are again putting pressure on our resources. Urea fertilizer is produced in the country. 60% of raw materials in its production is natural gas. Vehicles are using CNG as their fuel, which also is a pressure. Number four, pressure on water resources. Laptop matters from industries are polluting water resources of Bangladesh. In this generation, lack of drinking water, fish living in this water are dying, polluted. Water is thrown to the sea through rivers, which is also polluting the sea. This is also generating natural disasters. Now, I am discussing about the population growth of Bangladesh. Bangladesh is a populous country. The population of the small country of the world is gradually increasing. The total population of this country in 1974 was 7.64 crore. In 1991, it was 11.15 crore. In 2001, it was 12.93 crore. In 2007, it was 14.6 crore. And in 2011, it was 14,97,72,364. In 2011, density of population was 834 per square kilometer. The density of population has gradually increased and become 904 in 2005, 953 in 2009, 990 in 2010, and 115 in 2011. Now, we will know the reasons of population growth in Bangladesh. Correct. Now, I am discussing about the causes of population growth. There are a number of reasons behind the growth of population, some of which are discussed below. Number one, birth and death rate. The main reason behind population growth or decline is birth and death. There is great difference between the gross birth rate and gross death rate of Bangladesh. Advanced medical treatment and expanded program on immunization have lessened the gross infant mortality rate here. This is one reason population is growing. According to one statistics report, every year some 25 lakh children are born here, while about 6 lakh people die. That means 9 lakh people are added to the population of Bangladesh per year. Therefore, it can be said the main causes of our population growth is high birth. Number two, child marriage, polygamy, religious superstition, and irregular use of birth control measures are controlling to the growth of population. Number three, expectation for baby, boy child among the rural families. Number four, poverty. Number five, lack of female education. Number six, ignorance and superstition. Number seven, lack of coordination among government and non-government levels. Number eight, lack of proper initiative for implementation and lack of effective communication. Implementation process of registering birth, death, marriage, and divorce is also not in proper shape. Number nine, employment for the unmarried young woman is slow. Correct. Look at the picture. Now, I am discussing about the effects of population growth. Population growth is increasing the dependent population in Bangladesh. As a result, Bangladesh has to spend a large portion of its development budget for their welfare. But there will be 40% dependent and 60% independent population in Bangladesh in next 3 decades. if we can properly utilize this independent section of population, pressure created by overpopulation is dealing adverse effect in all spheres, including education and health. In the previous lesson, you have learned how it's creating pressure on our natural resources. Overpopulation is also largely responsible for social problems like drug addiction, sexual indiscipline, smuggling, cruelty towards women, smuggling women and children, etc. If we fail to turn the huge population into human resource, we have to face the consequences in near future. Cadet, I am discussing about the steps for solution of population problem. First, we need proper implementation of Child Marriage Act. We have to impose the law of minimum age of marriage strictly, just like boys 21 and girls 18 years. Number two, we need to create employment for women hope in productive sectors and involve them. Number three, we need to motivate everybody to take birth control measures and from similar families. Number four, we need to turn the population into human resource. We need initiative to ensure proper education, training, medical treatment, accommodation, etc. with the view to achieving this goal. The skilled human resource will not only fit in our national level, they will also do good abroad. Correct. Observe the sample question. Firstly, you look at the CQ question. Secondly, you observe sample question of MCQ part one. Next, you observe the sample question of MCQ part two. Now, home task. Number one, what is meant by child mortality? Number two, explain the effects of child mortality. Number three, discuss the causes of population growth. Cadets, if you any call, then ask me through message. I will be available here. Okay, dear cadets, thank you for attending my online class. I hope you will try to follow the instruction that I hope given you here. Now a very important point for you, dear cadets. You know, we are now passing a very tough time due to COVID-19. Going outside has become very much risky for all. So never make any plan to go outside for any reason. Spend your time with your parents and other family members of your house. Never neglect your regular study. You should be punctual, attending your online classes as well. Stay home and stay fine, dear cadets. Dear cadets, thanks a lot. Khuda Hafiz.